Republicans want to keep the filibuster going as long as they can. Texas Republican John Cornyn is helping to lead that charge, and he joins us now. Your perspective in brief, Senator Cornyn, on the payoffs in this context. I'll ask you the same way I asked Senator Leahy. This has been going on for a long time in this country. We live in a very transparent world. It's 2010, and boy, oh boy, we can see a lot of money flying around on this one. What's going on in that town, and what can you do about it?
Well, Dylan, it's not transparent enough. The president, who paid some lip service to transparency when he was sworn in, and then when he was talking about how this bill would be negotiated, talked about the transparency, but yet we know there were special deals cut for the drug companies, for the insurance companies, for various health care providers in this bill. And then we know, as you just pointed out, there were a bunch of sweeteners thrown in for senators who apparently couldn't find their way to vote for this bill based on the merits. So they had to get some sort of payoff. We've heard about the Louisiana Purchase, the Cornhusker kickback, and a whole host of other names. But this is pretty unseemly stuff, and I don't blame the American people for being repulsed by it. I certainly am.
Understood. I asked Senator Leahy about this from the other side of the aisle just a few moments ago. Here are his comments.
If they had won, if the Republicans had won and been able to kill health care, then they would say whatever it took for them to kill it would be absolutely wonderful. No, this is crocodile tears on their side.
Again, the argument, this is business as usual. It just happens that the Democrats are using it to win. Do you agree with that?
No, I don't. And Republicans are not out to kill health care reform. We agree there are things that could be done to bring down the price of health care to make it more affordable. But this bill doesn't do that. What this bill does is puts into law a bunch of special interest backroom deals. And you know what? I don't understand the rush to do this during this week when most of the provisions of the bill, other than the taxes, don't go into effect until 2014. Yeah. So this is an effort to jam it through despite the fact the American people have said they don't want it. So you have to wonder, who are folks listening to?
Yeah, Senator, the thing that has really struck me over the past few days as I've looked at the details of this legislation and all the no list, not only no public option, but no, again, choice, no, again, access to the exchange for the vast, only 9% of the people in the country would have a look at the exchange, no end to the monopolies, no Medicare buy-in, effectively, other than pre-existing condition, which I think is, again, very sellable and valid thing, there's almost no reform, but there is expanded coverage. I add to that the mandate to participate, which is understandable in a reform market, as we have car insurance works because everybody needs it at some point. We're watching a mandate into an unreformed monopoly that, to your point, is a boon, a windfall. As sure as there's a windfall profit at the banks from the bailout without strings, we are now delivering a windfall profit to monopoly health insurers with a mandate without choice.
That's right. The primary beneficiary under this bill are going to be the insurance companies that are going to receive a tax credit directly payable to them to pay for the subsidies under this bill. You've heard our friends on the other side of the aisle demonize the insurance industry, but this is a $400 billion-plus transfer of tax dollars to the insurance companies. This is not reform. This is about basically growing the size of government and its intervention in our lives and getting between us and our doctors when it comes to making choices for our own health care.
Understood. Very quickly, what would you do? In other words, if would you look at Wyden-Collins, you look at vouchers, you look at putting the tax credit with people, you look at breaking the monopoly. Very quickly, if you had a crack at this and a blank piece of paper, what would you do?
Well, you mentioned some of those. We would have interstate competition. We would be able to buy insurance across state lines. You'd be able to buy the kind of policy that you wanted that suited your needs. If you're young and invincible, you could buy a catastrophic policy. If you wanted to buy a health savings plan like they have at Whole Foods in Austin, Texas, you could do so. But this bill doesn't allow people to do any of that because it mandates minimum coverage dictated by Washington, and it's going to bust the budget, as we all know. All the assumptions made by the Congressional Budget Office about these Medicare cuts, we know from sad experience, will never come to pass. The doc fix, the Medicare provider payments, is just perhaps the best example where Congress has overridden it every time except one when that cut was supposed to take effect.
Yeah, Senator, thank you so much for the time. I do hope we can continue this conversation in the months and years to come.
Thank you.
All right, Senator John Cornyn, thank you, sir. Straight ahead here.